Welcome to Lafayette, Louisiana, home to the Raging Cajuns of the University of Louisiana and the site of the clash we have in store for you today. Today, a showdown of a couple of foes from the Sun Belt. As we'll see, the Marshall Thundering Herd taking on the Louisiana Raging Cajuns. Glad to have you with us for EA Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack and Jesse Palmer with me in the booth. Guys, we are ready to tee it up. Marshall will kick off to get the festivities started. He'll bring it out from inside his own 10. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The Raging Cajuns offense will get the first swing of the game. And here he comes, a man who epitomizes the phrase, the tight end's always open, David.
And yes, he is, Reese. And it's so cool. The tight end position now has evolved so much. You can move him all over the field, and you can really highlight a guy of his ability.
Too big for safeties to cover and too fast for linebackers to cover. This is a weapon they've got to take advantage of.
And a really good job by the quarterback being very decisive. He saw his matchup, he went for it, he attacked it, got the positive gain. I would say he's going to find that guy a few more times today.
And the Raging Cajuns want to move quickly. Comes out throwing on first down. Quarterback doing what he does best. He can move. He's brought down, but not before he turned that into a positive play and picked up a few on the run.
You see a lot of quarterbacks get in trouble when they start forcing things. He did a really good job. He wanted to throw the football. You could tell, drops back, nothing open. It's okay. I'm just going to take off and get what I can get.
They'll line up for a second down play. They'll run play action. Grabbed in the backfield. It's Carter. Wrestled to the ground after picking up the first down.
Well, it's a nice job, too, the quarterback after the play fake there, getting his eyes down the field. He had to get that to his tight end quickly, knowing he wasn't going to have a lot of space to run with after the catch.
The Raging Cajuns have it with a first and 10. He's looking to throw it. Fires to the big fella, and he'll run across the sidelines after the good game.
Must be nice for this quarterback knowing he's got this type of athlete playing the tight end position that can work the middle of the field for him. He's a guy who can stretch it vertically as well, but this is a guy the QB will look for early and often in this game.
That last completion sets him up on second down. They think they can impose their will here with the run to the right. Able to squeeze out a couple on the play. It's down at the 35.
All right, well, the offense here, they're trying to get this run game established. They obviously don't break off a long run there, but they're just trying to find their footing at this point.
Third and short here from the 35. Might take a shot here if this is four down territory. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. Just what they'd hoped for on third down as they've got a first at the 32.
This offense knew coming into this one, guys, how important it was to start early. And on this opening drive for them, they're doing a nice job running the football there on third down. They're in a position on the field now. If you're on defense, you got to be ready for a shot throw into the end zone.
Wants to throw on first down off the play fake. Fires toward the end zone. And he's got it! Touchdown, Cajuns! Quarterbacks love receivers that can get separation, but that amount of separation is a little excessive.
I agree, Reese, and I think the defense needs to have a little powwow on the sidelines and talk about what just happened, because that was an absolute busted coverage on the back end. Defense can't keep playing like that.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the PAT makes it 7-0. So it's an 80-yard drive, and they cap it off with a 32-yard touchdown pass. They're lining up to boot it away. Looking for blockers. And the returner goes down. So the Marshall Thundering Herd has the ball for the first time, and their offense will go to work. As we take a look at our impact players for this one, what are you looking for, Jesse, for a guy to make an impact?
Well, these are simply put the leaders of this football team, and generally games go how these guys play. If they make plays, then they've got a shot to win this one.
No doubt. They got to show up. These are the team leaders. These guys have to play well if they're going to win the football game.
Stuck with a running game on first down. Now here they come again. Looking to throw. It's quick. Quick strike complete. And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short gain. They were able to make the completion, but he had to pick his way for just a little bit. Needed a little more help to spring him for some yardage.
Yeah, if you're going to have success when you throw it outside like that, you're going to need some more blocking and better blocking downfield. Give the defense credit, though. They were able to rally and made a tackle.
From the gun, wants to pass. And this is going to be incomplete on third.
And I like the aggressiveness on third and short, trying to throw the football, take advantage of a look that they got. They weren't successful, and now it's fourth and short territory. Who knows what they're going to do?
Marshall will be forced to punt. This will be their first punt of the afternoon. On the return, it's Perry. They'll put a stop to that return as he gets it up to the 41-yard line. Here comes the Louisiana offense onto the field. Man, what a drive last time for the touchdown. That passing attack was lethal, David.
Yeah, and you know, you hear all these stupid commentators like me and Jesse talking about create balance, you know, run and pass. No, when you throw that good, spin the ball around.
So the defense has to find a way to affect the quarterback on this drive, because last drive, he had way too much time to throw.
9-yard pickup on first down, and now they can take a shot on second and short. They'll try the right side. Nifty little dance step. He's run out of bounds, but he's got enough to move the sticks. We'll repeat the previous down, but this time the offense has 10 more yards it has to cover. Red pass, it's complete. He knew exactly where he wanted to go with that one, and they've got enough for the first down.
And that's just a great individual effort by the wide receiver. He catches this ball way short of the sticks, but because he's able to make the defender miss, now he's able to get the extra yards and turn that into an explosive play.
The offense getting set for a first down from the 45. The give to the tailback. That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there.
I like feeding my guy. I like getting my running back touches, feeding the ball so he can break some of those big runs. But I'm also okay with these little ones. Set the tone, stay balanced.
After the 3-yard pickup, they come to the line, 2nd and 7. Off play action. Fires to the wideout. Makes a connection. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
When on that outbreaking route, really it's designed for the receiver to make the catch before falling out of bounds. Nice timing and anticipation by the quarterback on that throw.
And the Raging Cajuns will hustle to the line. Off play action on first down. And it's picked off. Going the other way, and he's got room. He's at the 40. He's at the 20. No one there to stop him, except the fella in the striped shirt who threw the penalty flag. This one might be coming back. So take the touchdown off the board. What a devastating penalty. Pass interference, waving off the pick six. Makes a man miss.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Going to work in the red zone. They can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. on second down, looking to throw. Caught near the sticks, it's Carter. Touchdown, Louisiana! What a grab and go for the score.
And this offense right now, they're doing some damage through the air. That's now their second passing touchdown. They thought coming into this game, they were going to have some matchups on the perimeter of the field that they could take advantage of, and they've done that so far here today.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. They got the ball in great field position and bam, bam, two plays and into the end zone. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the five. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. Marshall takes over the ball, the thundering herd offense coming out. To say this has been a slow start is a bit of an understatement, and they really need to get it going here, Jesse.
That's right. The opponent, they're firing on all cylinders right out of the gate. Offensively for this unit, they've been slow and struggling. They need an explosive play to wake themselves up.
Yeah, and it's just the first quarter, so it's not the end of the world. You've seen slow starts, but you got to continue to pick and pick and pick until you find that play or that scheme that you can use against this defense.
Unloads to the wideout. And the senior would love to have that one back, just a little too much on the pass.
Man, as a quarterback, you got to be careful. He's lucky there. If you miss high throwing over the middle of the field, oftentimes that results in interceptions, so lucky that ball was incomplete.
After the second down misfire, looking at a third and eight. Now they'll run the draw. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, the linebacker showing you read and react. He knew exactly where that running play was going, and he beat the football to the line of scrimmage and forced the TFL.
Marshall will be forced to punt. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. They'll put a stop to that return as he gets it up to the 41-yard line. Louisiana has it back, and the Raging Cajun offense headed to the field. On the run, it's Perry. And he'll find enough running room to get it just short of midfield at the 49.
Well, it's plays like that that'll help this offense stay in rhythm all game long. If you can have that kind of success on first down running the football, it just opens up your entire playbook moving forward.
They can really be aggressive after that last play at second and three. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. And they'll bring him to the ground after a short gain.
And the running back didn't get much there. Nice job by the defense. You can tell they're focused in on this running back, on this run game, being physical, getting knockbacks, and limiting his carries.
In the dead center of the field as they try to convert this third and short. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. That'll be enough for the first down as they stop him at the 43-yard line.
All right, defense, that's what we can't do. We can't give up this many chunk yards on the ground. Got to commit more guys to the line of scrimmage. Got to get those running backs on the ground. That's way too easy.
The Raging Cajuns have it with a first and 10. Power football with the run. Really nice stop there from this senior leader.
And the defense doing a great job committing to the run. When you commit to the run like this, obviously you can give up some plays in the passing game, but you got to stop the run first.
As they get set to snap it, just about to reach the end of the quarter. Off the play fake. And it'll be incomplete. This defense is physical and pass deep.
What a hit by the defender. That's a good throw, and that was going to be caught, but how about the defender dislodging the football from its intended target? Nice job.
One final play before the end of the quarter. On third and long, he has to throw for it. Catch in the middle, it's Johnson. He'll come through on third downs. He's got enough, and they'll mark it at the 23. That's going to do it for the quarter, guys. Louisiana has the lead here. They wanted to strike first and strike hard, and they've been able to do that here in the first quarter as we take a look at the stats. Now, the challenge here, they've taken a punch, but they can't let it get out of hand as we start the second. Moving the running back, forcing the defense to adjust. Going for it all. And good coverage and better hands on that shot to the end zone.
This defense is going to have to make some adjustments here at halftime because they have been taken advantage of deep down the field in the passing game. They've already given up two TD passes. That was almost number three, and we're only in the first half.
Now on second down after the incompletion. Give to the running back. They get him on the ground with this running game imposing its will. 6 yard gain down to the 17.
It's going to be important this offensive line is able to get a little bit of push. Just got to give this guy an inch, a little crease, and he can make yards for you.
They'll come to the line needing 4 yards for a first down. They're already 2 for 2 on this drive. From the gun, he'll try to throw for it on third down using the quick game. And he'll be taken down, but he does have enough for the first down.
Really nice job there by the quarterback, understanding that it's zone coverage on third down. You're going to have to find someone working into a soft spot, get the ball out of your hands quickly, make an accurate throw, and pick up the first. Well done.
Down to the 12-yard line. It's first down. Out of the gun. The running back has it. Just couldn't get away from the tackle.
Great job of contained by this defense. And in order to do that, the end man on the line of scrimmage defensively has got to be able to set the point and force the football back into traffic. And that's exactly what happened there.
Operating in the red zone here on second down. He's looking to throw. He makes a grab. Couldn't quite nudge it in. Not sure you could get much closer, but it'll be first and goal.
How about this offense? They're rolling. They got a couple first downs together. Defense, next, what's your response? What do you got? You got to make some adjustments here.
And the Raging Cajuns have it in scoring position on first and goal. Powers forward. And they just tried to slam it in from the doorstep, but they went nowhere, and it'll be marked down at the one.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
Can the D deny them on second and goal? They'll run it to the left, looking for the end zone. Going right back to the well, and this time he finds water. Gets it into the end zone for the touchdown. Follow the blockers. The offensive line will take you to the hallelujah land.
And I tell you what, most of the time, Reese, it requires a little bit of skill to find that hole and, you know, slither through a little crack. That was not a crack. That was wide open. Didn't take a lot of vision because the blocking was outstanding.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And with the extra point, they're up 21-0. Precise, relentless execution on that 13-play scoring drive. And they capped it off with a 1-yard plunge. About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. He'll start the return inside his 5. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. The Marshall offense makes its way back onto the field. Trailing by 3 touchdowns, if you're going to get back in it, David, the time to start is right now.
Got to start now. Defense giving up points on that last possession again. The offense is going to have to score, and Jesse probably score pretty quickly.
Yeah, you got to go tempo. You're going to have to try to fit in as many plays as you can throughout the rest of this game. But I think more than that, you got to eliminate the negative plays. No more penalties and no more turnovers.
Pocket starts to collapse. And the defense makes a play, sacking him back at the 10.
How about the aggressive play calling? Love aggressiveness, bringing the free safety down, blitzing him, you could tell, completely disrupted the offense. They didn't know how to handle it. Free safety chases the QB, gets him on the ground.
You make up the game plan and not a lot on the play sheet for this. Third and long from inside their own 20. Looking to throw and he needs a bunch. Quickly complete. And he's not going to get there. The defense stands tall and makes the stop.
Well, they weren't able to gain a lot of real estate on that last completion deep down in their own end. If anything, if you're looking for a silver lining, I guess the punter maybe has a little bit more room to try to get one off now on fourth.
Marshall will be forced to punt. He'll try to really get into this one. Slips through the line. Not able to pop the big return, but they've got the ball back and ready to go with a fresh possession. Here comes the Louisiana offense onto the field. This has been exactly the way you draw things up, David. The offense has really been moving the football.
And it's been great execution. They've done exactly what they've wanted to do. Build the lead. Now Palmer's a different animal. Now you got to protect it.
You can tell they were paying attention in practice this week in the film room because they have gone out everybody right now on the same page.
Line getting set on second down. Trying play action. Might be looking to run. He'll try to do it himself. They make the stop, but what a job on the scramble to get loose and pick up that first down.
Sometimes these guys just have eyes in the back of their head. You saw it right there. He was able to buy himself time, get outside the pocket, and at that point, I think the decision was pretty easy. Hey, I can go get this with my feet. And he was able to do that. Now they got a fresh set of downs.
They've got a first and 10 at the 34. They'll go to the ground. You'll take 4 yards on first down every time, second and 6.
Listen, I know that's not a huge gain, but those run plays add up. They make you tackle the back every single play. Physically, you have to get some guy on the ground. It takes its toll throughout a fourth quarter game.
Solid pickup of 4 on first down. It's 2nd and 6. He's looking to throw. Grab near the marker. It's Carter. They make the stop, but not before they do their work up top and pick up a first down. They wanted to get the ball to the tight end, and they've already done it 5 times, and we're not even to the half.
I'm about to say, mission accomplished. Yeah, that's what they want to do. Take advantage of the matchup, right? Zone or man, I like my big fella. I like using the tight end all I can. Great job working him into the offense. He's a playmaker. Find him.
Runs through a tackle. Touchdown, Raging Cajuns! That is the ultimate grab and go for the score.
One of the reasons this offense is so exciting to watch, they've got guys that are dangerous after the catch. And if this quarterback gets through his progression, David, hits you in stride, these guys will take it to the house.
Man, it's your job to do the rest, right? You hit me in stride where I don't have to stop running. I don't have to break down. It makes it so easy, the connection between quarterback, wide receiver. You can tell this is a good one, and that's why they got 6 on that play.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point makes it 28-0. A very efficient 5-play scoring drive. And they close the deal with a 16-yard throw for the touchdown. The kickoff team takes the field to boot this one away. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Marshall takes over the ball, the thundering herd offense coming out. Got his man quickly. Powers through the defender. At the 35, he's got room. And he's down at the 41. That's a first down.
And I love the idea of getting this guy screen throws because of his ability after the catch. So nice job getting downfield, getting a hat on hat, and giving him a tunnel to run through.
One play in this drive and already out to the 41. It's first down. Handoff to the single back. Continuing to turn and move it forward, and they're closing in on midfield. It's down at the 48.
You want to talk about making it easy for an offensive coordinator. You pick up a bunch of yards on first down, make that second down really, really manageable. That's a great job by the offense.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on first down. It's second and 3. Out of the gun, the inside handoff, looking for a crease. They'll finally drag him down, but not before he gets it to the 40, and it's a first down.
And here we go. If you're an offense, you got to get that ground game going so you can have some balance, and then you give it to your quarterback, Palmer, and let him make some plays down the field later on.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, coming into this game, this offense knew they were going to have to some way, somehow, at least establish a semblance of a running game for exactly what you just said. You got to be able to use play action pass later in this game to get some explosive plays down the field. And it's a play like that that we just saw, which can help them get that going.
Second down after that incompletion. A little pre-snap eye candy for the defense. Caught in the backfield, it's Turner. Across the 25, he's got room. And he almost ran away from everybody on that one. A huge pickup on that play.
And this defense is going to have their hands full because they're going to need to be comfortable with guys one-on-one on islands in the perimeter of the field. And they're just going to have to make better plays than what we saw right there. They knew this offense was going to try to be aggressive. Got to need better effort in the back end for this defense moving forward.
We've made our way to the 2-minute warning, and now they'll try to at least cut a little something off of this lead before the break. Not the most productive half for this offense so far, but finally starting to get it in gear. First and 10. Looking for the score. Snagged in the end zone. Touchdown, Marshall!
Man, nice job getting the passing game going. This is big, man. Going into the half, and listen, I know you're trailing, but building some momentum, maybe this second half we can keep airing the football out, cutting into this deficit, and who knows what the heck will happen.
Lining up for the PAT. The extra point is good, but they're still down 28-7. So that scoring drive took only 6 plays. And they finish it by firing one in from the 13 for the score. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. On the run from inside his own 5. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. Louisiana has it back, and the Raging Cajun offense headed to the field. They're bringing heat. On the move, he fires. Got his man downfield. That is exactly what you're looking for when you talk explosive plays. The defense finally able to make the stop.
Well, they wanted this guy catching the ball on the right side of the field. They could have just lined him up over there, but they didn't that time. He started off on the left side. He crossed the defense and made the catch on the right side of the field.
Perfect play call for that big gain to open the drive. Now here they come on first and 10. Fires to the tight end. The modest gain on the completion really shows why you want to run the zone. Make them execute and rally to the ball.
100%. Zone eyes on the quarterback. I see him throw the football, break on it, go make tackles, live to fight another down.
Offense gets set for second down. He's looking to throw. Receiver looks it in, it's complete. And he's knocked down, but not before moving the chains.
Man, how about the first half this guy's having? He already has 2 touchdowns, picks up a huge first down right here. On defense, you're going to have to find a way to control this guy. You're going to have to make some big-time adjustments at halftime.
The Raging Cajuns getting set on first and 10. Looking to move it through the air. And the pressure gets to him. Down goes the quarterback. The offense will have to use its first timeout of the half.
And that's what this defense needs to get going. You've given up a bunch of touchdowns. You haven't been great early, but now you finally get some pressure, get the quarterback to the ground. Now maybe start turning this defense around.
Incomplete. And man, is he lucky to get that one back. Defense that close to an interception.
Well, things have mostly been going right for this offense in this game so far. That's why they have the lead they have. But that time, a little bit of a mental error. That should have been intercepted. Don't love the decision by the quarterback.
Even if they don't convert, picking up a few would give them a decision to make on fourth down. It's third and long from the 45. There's a timeout on the field. Tight game here late in the first half. And the Raging Cajuns will send out the punt unit. Boy, they had a chance to track that thing down, but it bounces into the end zone for a touchback. The Marshall offense makes its way back onto the field. To the air on first down. They find themselves in a pretty deep hole here, but maybe a chance to grab a little momentum and regroup at halftime.
Yeah, a big chance. Like, this is an opportunity. This is the biggest opportunity in front of them in the game right now. You got to get some points on the board. You got to create something positive, Jesse. There hasn't been a whole lot to be positive about in the first half.
If I'm playing quarterback, I'm locating my go-to guy at receiver. Who can I count on one-on-one to go and make me a play? Maybe even one-on-two. Who can go up, catch the ball, get us some yards, and get us some points?
After the incompletion, it's second down. Back to throw, it's quick. Quarterback moving out of the pocket. And he can't find a receiver, and down he goes. A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. It'll take some work to get to the sticks. It's third and long from the 30. Looking to throw, and he needs a chunk play. Just had to get rid of that one to save the yardage on third down.
That's why it's so important for this defense to win first and second down. You set up third and longs like that, you can show your exotic looks, you can get the pass rush going, everybody in the back end expecting throw, and that's how you force incompletions and force fourth downs.
Marshall will be forced to punt. Fourth time tonight we've seen this guy come on to punt. No return coming. He'll call for the fair catch. Time dwindling away as they try to put points on the board right before the half. Hand off from the shotgun. Got to be smart, patient, great vision. Uses all of that to get to the 29. That's going to wrap up the first half here, and now we join Kevin with a halftime update.
All right, guys, looks like we've got a great atmosphere today in Lafayette. And we'd be remiss if we didn't start this halftime report by acknowledging the sparkling play of this tight end. The guy's like an aircraft carrier out there as a blocker, and then when he releases and shows off that speed and route running, he's almost unguardable. Gotta believe he won't be able to go anywhere in this second half without someone attached to his hip. And with that, let's send it back to the fellas inside Our Lady of Lourdes Stadium.
The Raging Cajuns will kick it away to crank up the second half. On the move from inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Marshall takes over the ball, the thundering herd offense coming out. They'll keep it on the ground to start the second half. They believe in that running game, got six before he stopped at the 23.
Coaches always harp about staying ahead of the chains, and when you can run with that type of efficiency on first down, man, you are doing just that.
6-yard pickup on first down leaves them with second and four. The give on the inside. Tackled after picking up the first down.
You got to have short area quickness. That running back there doing what it takes to make sure he got that first down.
Marshall quick to the line. Going up top on first down. Throws to the wideout. Finds space on the right. That's the kind of play that can really get you going as they have a first down at the 43. Curl route seems simple, but when you time it like that so it's right on him, man, that's a tough play to stop.
And give the receiver a lot of credit, too, because he knew where the sticks were. He got his depth on the route, and then he came back to the football. All young receivers can learn from this guy right here. Come back to the ball and help your quarterback out.
Use the play fake. Now to throw. And it was worth going for a chunk play, but the long pass is incomplete.
Well, at this juncture in the game, with how the scoreboard looks, no question this offense is going to have to throw to get back in the game. And it's going to be tricky now because the defense is expecting it. You're going to throw into a lot of big zone coverages with everybody's eyes on the quarterback. Not going to be easy.
To the air. It's quick. Quickly complete.
And a great job understanding where you're at on the field. And I know that sounds very simple, but I run that out route, I start getting towards the sidelines. I gotta feel it. I don't have time to look down as the ball's coming to me. Great job catching it and getting that foot in bounds.
Third down, and this offense is already in a world of trouble. They could really use a conversion, not to mention multiple scores. The play action fake. Fires to the middle. Wide open downfield. And this defense's head is spinning. He gets it down to the 27. This dude is just exceptional in every facet. So fluid, such a great route runner, and a big play there.
And money down, third down, find him. I mean, you want to find that matchup because he's going to win. And gets a good release, gets down the field. You see his, that's your playmaker, that's your guy. Get it to him, get the first down.
Looking to throw it again. Unloads it left. He's got it on the run. Defense makes a stop, but the chains move, and it's first and goal from the 8.
Great job by the quarterback throwing against zone coverage. You cannot telegraph where you're throwing the football. You cannot eyeball wide receivers. So great job by the quarterback using his eyes, not staring down his guy, and then throwing him open.
They'll try to get it in with the run. He works his way all the way down to the 3, and the defense is reeling.
I like this guy as a running back because he can run between the tackles and he can also go outside. He can really do it all.
They've got it down to the 3. Now it's second and goal. Tries again to get it in. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Thundering Herd. Got to start cutting into this lead somewhere. Now the question, will they have enough time?
But that's step one. You got to get that first score. You got to get back in the ball game and get some of that momentum back on your side. You still got more work to do, but step one accomplished.
Lining up to add another. And with the extra point, they trail by 2 touchdowns, 28-14. They go 83 yards on the drive and close the deal with a 3-yard touchdown run. They've got it down to a 2-touchdown deficit, trailing by 14 and about to kick it away. Here he comes from inside his own 5. And the returner will be knocked down. Here comes the Louisiana offense onto the field. He'll start this drive firing. Grabbed behind the line, it's Perry. And good coverage by the defense, just a short gain.
And you see so many smart wide receivers, so many smart tight ends nowadays that they know where the holes in those zones are, and they work with their quarterback, and they find them, and they sit down in them and make big plays. It's tough to sit back in zone against such smart players nowadays.
Quarterback on the keeper. Brought down to the ground, but he has enough for the first down.
Such an advantage when you have an athletic quarterback today in college football because they can help you move the sticks with their legs. Great open field running ability by this QB.
It'll be a first and 10 from the 29. Running to the left. He's got a yard out to the 30-yard line. Didn't get much on first down. It's second and 9. The give to the running back from the shotgun. Defense there to stop him after a 2-yard gain to the 31.
Man, a nice second effort by the back to break a tackle. But how about those defensive backs willing to come up, stick their face in the fan, and make a tackle?
Those are the best run defenses too, right? It's not just D linemen and linebackers getting all the plays, but it's DBs that are willing to not just cover, but tackle backs in the open field.
Keeps looking downfield. Sweet feet on the move. They finally get him on the ground, but not before he rips off enough for a first down.
You can tell this is a pass play. He has his eyes down the field. He's looking to throw the football. But how nice is it when you got a guy like this that can scramble and go get you a first down? Just really hard to stop from a defensive perspective.
Hand off from the gun. Creating some space, getting just enough good blocking, and they've got it up to the 47-yard line.
I know it's sexy to throw the football, but if you can pound it away and get these kind of gains, they will just add up, wear the defense down, get first downs, and ultimately get some points.
They can really be aggressive after that last play. It's second and 3. Now he's looking to throw it. Fires left. And that's going to be incomplete. A lot of contact on the play, but no flags. It'll be third down.
Missed opportunity on offense. QB and receiver just not on the same page there.
Just shy of midfield at the 47. The defense needs a third down stop. Now the play fake. Flushed out of the pocket. He is brought down, but man, what a job to find some running room and move the chains.
Sometimes you just got to give credit. Like, we had it covered. We knew it was a pass. Everything covered underneath, but the quarterback does such a good job of making that second play something special, pulling it down, getting the first down pretty easily.
And the Raging Cajuns will snap it on first and 10. Makes the catch. It's Bernard. And they pick up just a few on that completion.
I love offenses and quarterbacks that are willing to take the easy stuff. Take those easy throws that are guaranteed to get positive yards. Yeah, I'm going to take big shots down the field too. But don't forget, it's easier to pick up second and 5, third and 5, than it is when we start getting those long yarded situations.
From the gun, they'll try the middle. They get him on the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down.
And David, how demoralizing does it have to be for a defense when you know they're going to run it, everyone in the stadium knows they're going to run it, and still you cannot stop it?
There's nothing more demoralizing as a defensive lineman, because it ticks you off. It gets in your head. You know that guy's going to come off and smack you, and you got to do something about it. I think the defense may be time to start committing more guys to stopping that run.
Can anyone catch him? Touchdown, Cajuns! And they add 6 more to the board with that trip to the house. And a huge run from the back for 6.
Man, it's nice to have a running back that can do that. That makes everything else easy on offense. Hey, hand it to that guy, he makes a big play. Yes, please.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point is true, and the lead balloons to 21. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the 5. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. The Marshall offense makes its way back onto the field. They're down by 21 points, but you get a touchdown here, and you do at least apply all kinds of running room. The 30. And they were looking for a chunk play, and they got it. The explosive picks up more than 30.
Yeah, and listen, QB's got to find ways to push the ball down the field and make sure defenses don't just sit in zones and stay shallow. Nice job by the QB. Push it down the field. Make some big plays, baby.
Marshall, quick to the line. They'll run it. It's Turner. And he'll pick up one. It brings up second and 9. Time winding down in the quarter as they come to the line. Running back searching for a hole. And they'll drag him down. That's likely the last play of the third quarter. These two quarterbacks have produced as we check out their numbers after 3. One more period to go, and we'll see just how much fight they've got left in them. Third and long, and they can get the first down without scoring a touchdown. Let's it fly. Reels it in the end zone. Touchdown, Hurd!
One of the areas they really focused on with this receiver in the offseason was, we need you to make more plays for us in the end zone. When we're taking shots, we need you to be able to step up and make tough catches. And David, what a grab right there.
And I think a lot of that has to do with trusting your guy, knowing where he's going to be, knowing when he's going to sit down, when he's not. So being on the same page, and then having a guy that can go get it. Just when the ball is near him, he's going to make the play, just like he did right there for 6 points.
PAT unit on the field. And the extra point is good, but they still trail 35-21. Quick work on that scoring drive, just 4 plays. And they finish it off by connecting from 10 yards out. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll start the return inside his 5. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Louisiana has it back, and the Raging Cajun offense headed to the field. He'll do it himself. Now they've got a little room to work with. They're out to the 28 with a first down.
Well, this is one of the fastest quarterbacks in college football, and that's why the option's a good idea, because if he can get out in space and he has a chance to get downfield, he is really difficult to tackle, and he's very difficult to catch, as you saw in that last play, getting a first down.
Leaves it with the back. He picks up maybe a couple before he stopped right at the 30-yard line.
At this point of the game, the offense has the lead. The offensive coordinator knows they want to keep running the football, so he's going back, he's looking at his playlist, and he's saying, which runs work the best for me in this game? What can I lean on right here to make sure we win this one?
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. He's looking to throw. With the catch, it's Carter. That defense got gashed, but they finally get him to the turf at the 47.
Defense just hasn't had an answer for this guy. He has been on point. This is about as good as I've seen him play at the quarterback position. And here in the fourth quarter with the big lead, he's still taking shots.
The Raging Cajuns are in the hurry up. Grab behind the line. It's Bernard. And a good job of coverage by that defense. Just a short pickup.
Great effort by the defense here. Offense trying to go wide receiver screen. How about the speed on defense rallying to the football?
Ran the ball on first down. Let's see what they do on second. Going to the running game. And the defense finally makes the stop after the sweet run and good gain.
I think you have to like what you see if you're the coaching staff here. Your offense is on the field, and it looks like you got a pretty good drive going, and you're just going to try and keep this thing marching, keep the clock ticking. You've got a really nice lead here late. Just want to find ways to keep the chains moving. They're doing that.
They'll throw it on first down. Snagged on the outside, it's Perry. And he'll step out of bounds after a very productive play.
This defense is going to have to be careful. Not only do they have to worry about this guy running the football, but they've got to keep their eye on him when he runs routes, too. He is a versatile back.
This offense could not have executed in this situation any better, just draining some time off the clock. The back goes in motion. Dialing up a second down pass play. Trying to escape and get it himself. Nifty little scamper on this one. Enough for the first down, and he slides in safely.
Yeah, I think you're just seeing the experience this guy has, right? He's so poised that initially he's flushed out of the pocket, nothing's open, and he doesn't panic. He's not throwing it away. He's not sliding early. He just knows where the defense isn't, and he's able to attack that space with his speed and get a positive play.
Got it in the middle. It's Jensen.
I love an offense that wants to stay aggressive. Even when you've got the lead late in a game like this, right, you still try to find your playmakers and get them the ball in space, and that is exactly what this offense is doing.
They've already peeled more than 3 minutes off the clock on this drive as they stand over the ball on second down. Going to the run, it's Perry. Slammed to the ground, but not before he gets the first down.
Everything going the offense's way. They're trying to ice this game late. They've got a really nice lead, so you just want to run the ball, high percentage throws, and keep the chains moving, and they're doing that. This has been a beautiful drive to watch. Offense continues to stay in a nice rhythm here late.
A first down run on the doorstep. Snowed under after a pickup of two. They'll mark it at the 8. Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. Caught in the backfield, it's Carter. And they get him, and they'll lose yardage on that completion.
Well, they're able to find the tight end for an easy completion, but good job tackling, not allowing him to get the first down.
A huge chance for points here on third and goal, and if they can get it in, we might have ourselves a finish. From the gun, wants to pass. Makes the grab, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Louisiana. Offense gets the job done again. You want to build that cushion as we get deeper into the second half.
Man, it makes it easy, doesn't it? You start getting up by a couple possessions, making the offense very predictable on the other side. Great job by the offense extending their lead.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And the extra point splits the uprights, and they're up a full 3 touchdowns, a 21-point cushion in the fourth. They're just about ready to kick it away. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. Marshall takes over the ball, the thundering herd offense coming out. Wants to throw on first down. Gonna let it fly. Wide open, he makes the catch. And the tackle is made, but not before that completion gets him 30-plus.
Let's go. We got some life. We made a big play, something to build off of. We need a lot of points, and we need them quickly. Time's running out. We're trailing big in this ballgame.
Marshall, quick to the line. Yeah. to throw. It's quick. Gets it out quickly. At the 20, he's got space. And he was loose and in the open field and on his way. A tremendous pickup on that one. That was a really nice catch and an even better run after the grab.
Yeah, and get that ball to your playmaker. What's good about having him in the slot is he can go either direction. You can get him matched up on somebody that's not as fast. And you watch, he can run away from those linebackers or safeties.
Trying to cap this drive with a pass. And it's incomplete as he was trying to finish the drive with a score.
At this point of the game in the fourth quarter, it is going to be tough for this offense to get some completions here because now, trailing by this much, the defense is expecting pass and they're putting a whole bunch of extra DBs on the field to help them out in coverage.
And now on second down for this offense. Quick completion to the right. Touchdown, Marshall! And they take it in for 6 more points.
And this receiver is on fire. He's got all the skills that you look for in a big-time target. And that's already his second touchdown of the game.
Ready to try the point after. Bangs it through for an extra point. Quick work on that scoring drive, just 4 plays. And the score comes on a 17-yard throw for the touchdown. They are running out of time here. They need to get the ball back. They'll line up for the onside kick. They were ready for the onside kick and executed perfectly, and they secure the football. Here comes the Louisiana offense onto the field. What a good mix of plays keeping that defense off balance last time, David.
And Reese, they don't know if it's run or if it's pass. They got them right where they want it. This defense doesn't know how to react from getting punched in the mouth on that last drive.
So in this next drive, David, I think you keep running the football because that sets up the play action, it sets up the RPO game, and then you keep this defense guessing.
After picking up a couple at 2nd and 8. We've reached the 2-minute warning, and this offense will be quite content just to drain the rest of the time away. They'll be perfectly content to go right back to the ground here on 2nd and 8. The handoff keep working on that clock. And he's able to shed one tackle, but still, just a very short gain. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. This is a big third down. If they can move the chains, they can just about salt this game away. From the shotgun, the inside give. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible.
Awesome job up front by this defensive line, being so good at the point of attack and eating blocks, eating some double teams that allows these linebackers to run free, unencumbered, and get to the football.
Splits the uprights from 56, and he's got 3 on the board.
Well, that kid just showed off his hammer for a leg, 50-plus, and he did it with ease.
That lead just keeps getting fatter, and this kickoff team doing a little running. On the run from inside his own 5. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. The Marshall offense makes its way back onto the field. They'll come out on this drive and let it rip. Just had to get rid of that one. Good job to fight another play.
It's a nice adjustment by the defense here. With a big lead in the game, you're putting extra DBs on the field, knowing the offense has to throw to get back in this one in the fourth quarter. So your best cover guys on the field, and they force an incompletion on the last one.
After that last incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from their own 20. Couldn't connect on first down, now back to the air. Not much of a chance there. He just had to get rid of it to avoid the sack. Now on 3rd and 10, if they can move the chains here, maybe they can get this drive started. To the air. It's quick. Fires to the wideout. A strike downfield. So important to convert these third downs, and they get it done. They'll have it at the 42.
Well, offensively, they knew they were going to have some matchups they could take advantage of in this one. And all of a sudden, this quarterback has now over 300 yards passing in the game. Defensively, David, he has got them on their heels.
And he's been showing you a little bit of everything. He can throw it all over the field to all different receivers, to his tight ends, to his running backs. Really has the ability to spread it around. And now over 300 yards. Still some time left. And he...
What a catch along the right sideline as he makes a huge play.
This is an offense that has skill, and they've got speed, and because of that, this defense, they can't lull themselves to sleep. They've got a bit.
And let's hold on just a minute here as the officials are going to have a second look. And the play will stand after the replay booth just does a little double checking to make sure. He wants to throw. Get it out on the screen. They finally get him stopped, but what a good job by that front wall to set up the screen and create some lanes for their running back. Plays like that put just a second of hesitation in the defense to make sure, and they're able to take advantage here.
And they use great timing with this call, right? Like, you can't call this play all the time, but you want to catch them when they're a little bit aggressive, not thinking about it. Nice job slipping the screen behind them, making the easy catch, and then getting downfield, picking up some extra yards.
Sixth play of the drive coming up. Looking to pass. It's quick. And that pass will be jarred loose on 2nd down. That brings up 3rd down. They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. On 3rd down, going up top. He caught it. He gets it in. Touchdown, Thundering Herd.
And a nice touchdown, continuing to fight, continuing to play. This one, it's pretty much over. Down multiple possessions this late in the football game. It would take a miracle, but nice job by this offense continuing to fight, push the ball down the field, make plays.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And it's up and good as they draw just a touch closer. They march 79 yards on the drive, and they close the deal with a 16-yard throw for the touchdown. They're definitely up against it. Time running out, down 2 possessions. They'll try the onside kick. Cool as a cucumber as the hands team makes a sure catch.
Yeah, and this is why you put your hands team on the field most of the time. When you know it's coming and you put those guys that are great catchers of the football, the first guys, what do? They go block. They go blow somebody up. The next guys catch the football, secure it, get your butt on the ground. And most of the time when you do this, the ball game is over.